Today I show you all the tricks to make your runcam footage likely look as good as your GoPro footage. I'm talking about changing your camera settings. Choose the right ND filter. Stabilize your footage. How to get super view with your non-GoPro camera. And the fun part, color grading. Spoiler, this is a little bit of work, and if you're like bot grinder, just set everything to auto and send it. Let's start with the camera settings. Download the RunCam app from the App Store and choose QR code configuration. You will set video quality to high, resolution to 4K extra view, sound to FPV, shutter 1/60th, ISO 100, flat color. On my last video about the RunCam, I told you about the jumping exposure. I have a fix for this problem. Set the exposure settings to +2 and the exposure will stay in place. Never let the camera choose the white balance automatically. Set your white balance to your lighting condition. If you fly in a bando, set the ISO to auto to deal with the changing lighting conditions. That's it, just hit apply and let your camera read the QR code. At first I tried milling ND filters on my CNC router, but with very questionable results. So I switched to TBS ND filters. I bought ND 4, 8 and 16. Printed a custom mount to fit them nicely. And the image quality of the TBS ND filters is way better than the Chinese plastic filters. Oh, and subscribe to my channel if you like to see how I make this TBU parts. I'm planning a guide how to set up your printer and choose the right filament, choose the settings, and maybe even how to design parts like this. Back to the ND filters. I use the ND16 filter on a very sunny day, the ND8 filter on a sunny day when I fly in a bando or on a cloudy day, and I use the ND4 filter for cloudy days and bandos. And I most likely use no ND filter when it's evening. Let's start the post-processing. Open Premiere and create a new project. Create a transparent layer as a new object. Set the size to 2880 by 2160 30 frames, which is 4K 4x3 format. Track the transparent layer in the timeline, then track your RunCam footage in the timeline. Go to the Effects tab and uncheck Uniform Scale. Set the width to 75% to get a 4x3 image. Remove the transparent video layer and export your video. I set a preset to adaptive high bitrate. And change the scale of the video to 2026 by 1520, which is 7K 4x3 image. I also set to constant bitrate and 60 megabits per second. change the file name and hit export. Close Premiere Pro and open SuperView. Drag the video you just created in the window. Unchanged runcam footage or footage in 4K won't work. You will get encoding error. This might take a little while depending on your CPU. SuperView will export the video in the same folder as the source file. Close SuperView and open Premiere Pro again. Create a new project. And drag in your SuperView file. For comparison, I also track the non-SuperView file in so you can compare. The extra view resolution from the RunCam looks very squished. And the dynamic stretched SuperView file looks more natural. To stabilize your footage, go to the Effects tab. Go to the folders on the right side and look for Video Effects, Distort, Warp Stabilizer. Drag and drop the warp stabilizer on your clip. Premiere Pro will start to analyze every frame of your clip. Change the method to position, scale and rotate. Check preserve scale. Set the smoothness to 1 to 5%. Since this would take a little bit long, I decided to take a small part of my clip and stabilize it. Again, drag the warp stabilizer on the clip. Result should set to smooth motion. For smoothness, I choose 2% and set the method to position, scale and rotation. And I also check preserve scale. Let's speed up things a little bit. As you can see, your image is a little bit cropped in. In my case, it's scaled to 103%. Try not to exceed around 105%, maybe. You can play around with the settings a little bit. For demonstration, I set borders to stabilize only. At the borders, you can now see what warp stabilizer actually does. Just smooths out a little bit of shakiness. I set it back to stabilize, crop and auto scale so you can see what it should look like. I really like just a tiny bit of stabilization, especially for freestyle. I think HyperSmooth from my GoPro is a little bit too much. But it smooths out most of the camera wobble. Keep in mind, this will not help if you have any cello problems. Now comes the fun part, color grading. Go to the Colors tab. I'm looking for the brightest spot in the clip to not overexpose it. Create an adjustment layer as a new object. Drag the adjustment layer to the timeline. Stretch it to the whole length of the clip. Now you can play around with the sliders until you like the result. You can hide the adjustment layer to compare your results with your ungraded footage. I also check the results with other frames in my clip. This is a very basic color grade. You can do all kinds of color effects, like in the clips in my intro, for example. Before I go to cutting, I always export the video at this point. Choose a file name and set the export settings to constant bitrate 60 megabits per second for best results. Hit export and wait. This might take a while. If you have any questions, leave a comment down below. Thank you for watching. If you like this video, please like and subscribe. And as a bonus, here's the full video. See you next time. Woo!